One of the things to consider in the herbicide resistant weeds issue is that the scientists have defined and broken down how herbicides work, again by herbicide mode of action. Then within certain modes of action, there's specific sites of action. Okay, and we designate those with numbers that refer to specific enzymes. Now the interesting thing is by specific sites of action, you'll see different frequencies of weeds developing resistance. So different sites of action, the weeds have different responses to this chemistry. So this is helpful in helping us build some of our herbicide resistant management plans. Site of action number one herbicides contain three chemical families that act on lipid synthesis. These herbicides are only active on grass plants and inhibit the ACCase enzyme and result in injury symptoms to growing points of the plant. The symptoms would be yellow to necrotic of young leaf tissue, and leaves in the whorl of the plant can easily be separated from the rest of the plant after 3 to 5 days after application. Site of action 2 herbicides contain five chemical families that act on amino acid synthesis. These herbicides inhibit the ALS acetolactate synthase enzyme, resulting in injury symptoms to plant growing points. Shortening of internodes, chlorosis, or purpling effective leaves of grasses is very common. Broadleaf plants exhibit yellowing of leaves and purple leaf venation. Site of action number 4 herbicides contain three chemical families and influence plant hormones and are known as growth regulators. Site of action 4 herbicides are synthetic auxins, a plant hormone that influences and bind to receptors that cause unregulated growth and development of the plants, characterized by bending and twisting of plant parts and unregulated growth, callus tissue, etc. Site of action 5 herbicides contain four chemical families that inhibit a critical step in photosynthesis. These herbicides inhibit a specific biochemical site in photosystem II electron transport process and the translocate upward in the xylem. This results in initial injury symptoms of yellowing and necrosis of leaf tips and margins of older leaves and progress to interveinal yellowing and leaf drop. Site of action number 9 herbicides act on aromatic amino acid synthesis. These herbicides interfere with the EPSP synthase enzyme, and they can result in injury symptoms to the growing points of plants, resulting in shortening of internodes, death of the growing point, and chlorosis and yellowing of grasses and broadleaf plants. Site of action number 10 herbicides inhibit a critical step in nitrogen metabolism in the plant. The herbicide inhibits a specific biochemical site that's involved in the conversion of ammonia to nitrate in the plant. Effective leaves become yellow and then move to a necrosis. Grass plants, you'll see yellow striping in the plant leaves before they become necrotic and die. Site of action 14 herbicides inhibit protoporphyrin oxidase, also known as PPO, a key step in the production of chlorophyll. As a result of this inhibition, these herbicides generate a great deal of free radicals that disrupt cell membrane structure. Resulting injury is confined to foliage that has come in contact with the herbicide. Effective leaves will become yellow or brown in color and eventually turn necrotic and fall off the plant. Reddish-brown spotting on a leaf surface may appear shortly after herbicide application. Site of action 27 herbicides inhibit plant pigment formation. These herbicides inhibit a specific biochemical site referred to as HPPD, which is essential in the production of plant pigments that protect chlorophyll from being destroyed by sunlight. This results in injury symptoms of white, yellow, or necrotic leaf tissue on both grass and broadleaf weeds.